So let's see how we deal with shortcuts in Excel. As you can see, I feel that normal shortcuts, you know, cut, copy and paste. Just like that, Control C you put for copy, and Control V
for paste.
So for in Excel, what we do for knowing shortcuts, we just move our cursor to an option. Okay, so you can see there is a screen tip, such as here it is showing for bold, Control plus B. Okay, when you hover your mouse to an option, it shows you a shortcut, but it is not available for all of the options. Okay, such as you can see for borders, it is not available. So what we have, what we do, we have an Alt key in our keyboard. Alt key, when we press Alt key, then you can see there are characters available here, such as in home key you are seeing a H keyword. In insert you will see N keyword.
Would you please repeat that?
What, sir?
Would you please repeat the last step?
I have just pressed Alt key from my keyboard.
Which key?
Alt.
Alt?
Let me show you.
Ah, okay. Yeah, I get it. Okay, Alt. A-L-T. Yes, Alt. Yes,
this one key.
Yeah, I get it.
Okay, so when you press one time, you will find there is some keywords coming to the options. Okay, so suppose I want to do, I want to create borders here. So what I will do, I know that borders is available in under home section and in this border option. Okay,
that's right,
font group. So what I will do, I will press Alt one time and release the key. I will not touch any key now. Then I will press H key one time under home, for going under in home tab. I pressed H, then there are lot more keywords available for every options, such as you can see here for borders, I am seeing B. There is
okay.
Okay. So for
yes.
But borders have so many other options also. So what I will do, I will press B. Then I can see lot other option opened and they have also keywords here. Then I use all borders. For all borders, it is showing me A keyword. So I will press A from my keyboard. So now you can see I have applied border to these cells. Okay.
Yeah.
So this is the shortcut options. Suppose that I want to merge cells. The selected cell I want to merge. So what I'll do, I will press Alt. Then in tab I will press H key. Then for merge and center, I can see there is M keyword, and merge in center is showing me C. So finally I got here merged cell from this shortcut.
Yeah.
Just like that, for every option there is a key available. What you need to do, just keep your mouse keep aside your mouse for some time and try functioning through keyboards. So
that's
in very less time you will learn lot of shortcuts. Because why we use keyboard shortcuts? Because generally our keyboard typing is much more faster then mouse movement. So when I want to do something, so easily I can do whatever I want and more fast with keyboard. Okay.
Yeah, that's right.
Suppose that I want to apply filters here. So I just fill some data here. Now I want to apply filter on this data. So what I will do, I will press Alt from my keyboard. Then I know that filter is available in data tab. So data tab showing me A. Then for filter it is showing me T. So here you can see I have applied filter to it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now again when I press Alt A T, so I find I have removed the filters. So for every option there is a shortcut. Okay.
Yeah.
Next, one more thing, when we deal with dialog boxes, so they have something different criteria for shortcuts. Suppose that most of the time we use this number under number, there is a arrow sign. When I click that on that, I will find a format cell dialog box. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now how to navigate between this dialog box? I will navigating between the tabs of this dialog box, such as number, alignment, font, border, fill, protection. What I will use, I will press Control from my shift keyboard, then I will press Tab one time. Okay. When I press Tab, then it is shifting now tab to tab.
Between, yeah.
When I want to go in reverse, then I will press Control plus Shift. Then I press Tab, then it will go in reverse order. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, what I want to do is, I know how to navigate in between tabs, but what about these options, horizontal, vertical and wrap text? Suppose that I want to apply wrap text here. So the major thing is that you can see there is a keyword highlighted here in each option, such as for wrap text, W has underlined in shrink to fit. K has single, that's underlined, and in merge cells M has underlined. So I want to apply wrap text here. There is a difference. It will be applied from Alt key, but previously when I applied shortcut with Alt key, then I pressed Alt just a single time and released my key. Here I will keep pressed my Alt. And while pressing Alt, I will press that keyword W. Okay.
Yeah, I get it.
Okay. Such as I want to apply shrink to fit, I will press K. I am toggling between it. I am again pressing. So it does checked and checked sign here. Now I want.
How did you move to shrink? I know how to do it for wrap text, but how did you move from wrap to shrink?
I just pressed Alt with K, not
okay.
Such that I want to go in horizontal, in text alignment. So I will press Alt key and press H. The option will be open here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now
in
this list, what I will do, either I can press the first character, such as C for center, J for justify, okay, or I can use my arrow keys here. So for applying any selected option, I will press enter. So it will be applied here. It is got selected here. Now here you can see there is OK button highlighted with green border.
Yeah.
That means when you press enter button from your keyboard, this option will be activated. Okay. So when I press enter button, the option will be applied here.
Okay.
Now for cancel, I will use escape key. Okay. So now you can easily move around to your options and apply any one of them and just press enter without moving your mouse. Okay, sir.
Yeah. Just pressing control and tab, right?
Yes, yes. Control tab and alt key will be pressed with the underlined character. Okay.
Yeah.
So
yes.
This is the basic shortcut module in Excel. Suppose that you want to learn some shortcuts. You want a list of shortcuts in Excel. So what you will do, you just press F1 key from your keyboard. It is for help. Or you can see here, there is a question mark here. You can press this one, or you can press F1 key from your keyboard for help.
Mm-hmm.
So here you will find just shortcut. You will type shortcut and search it. Okay, there is a so when you press shortcut, you will find lot of options, but we need to understand that Excel shortcut and function key, all the shortcuts is available in this option. Okay, so when you see this option,
mm-hmm.
you have the key combination with control shift. There are a lot of, and what it does, unhide any row within selection. So with the combination control shift, you have lot of shortcuts. Control 1, Control 2, Control 3. What type of formatting it applied. With the control keyword, there are a lot of shortcuts. And with the function keys such as F1, F2, F3, what it does, here it is written. Then with arrow keys, control plus arrow key, control shift arrow key. So this is
time saving.
When you press control with arrow key, I am pressing control, and now arrow key I am pressing right arrow key. So it will directly move to the end of the data. Okay. If there is no data, it will move to the end of the row. This end of the column. Okay. Now I am pressing left key, so it will take me to beginning. Suppose that I want to select also. I want to move in that this direction and select also. So what I will do, I will press shift key with my control key. So when I press left key, it will select this one. And when I press down key, it will select my data. Okay. So for selection of data, what we will do, control shift, right, down. Okay. So this is your selection key. You can press control up, control down while moving in rows. Okay. So there are a lot of more shortcuts. You just take this list, just read it out so that you can understand what are the shortcut types you can use in Excel, which are the shortcuts which is given by default in that. So here is a list for shortcuts. Now let's move to Excel customization of Excel. Why we do customization? Because Excel is a very vast application, and sometimes there are settings which are disturbed, and you will face lot of problem due to it. Okay, such as you don't know where is the developer, how to open this developer tab. So it is under your settings. It is a part of customization, changing color of your application. And you can see there is 5 sheets by default in my Excel. Mostly it is 3. So it is by default. You can see the font also. This is Arial and size is 12, but I never applied that. So it is by default. I have make a preset of it. Okay, so you can see there is a office button. You just press one time and you just go to Excel options.
Okay.
There are a lot of settings here available here by which you can customize your Excel. So let's start with our first option. Suppose that you are typing any text and want to format it here from here itself. So you can see there is a mini toolbar available here for quick help. Okay. When you select this text under any cell, sometimes it never appears. So why it should it not appears? Because this option in popular tab, this show mini toolbar, if it will be unchecked by mistake, it was unchecked, then it will never appear.
Which one? Which option?
You go to in office button, Excel option, in popular tab, this option, the first one.
Okay, it's the mini toolbar. Okay.
I would suggest that when you practice this customization option, keep it correct while practicing, because once you forget, you will never find where it was. Okay, before you advertise on that. Okay, such as I just select a cell, I go to any cell style. So you can see there are instant changes in my cell, my selection area. This is called live preview. Still I have not clicked any option, but it is keep changing here.
Yeah.
This is called live preview. Somehow it is not appearing. Then go to Excel options in popular tab. Second option is for that. Enable live preview. If it will be off, then you can't see any changes here.
I see.
So just click this enable live preview. The third option is show developer tab in ribbon. Here you can see a developer tab I am having, which is useful for VBA. Most of the time we use it for VBA and macros and applying form controls. So this tab will be available when you go to Excel option in popular tab, you will check this option. Show developer tab in ribbon. Okay. Then there are color schemes of Excel. You can see my screen is black. Yeah, you can see it is black. In black shade, black theme. So I'll go in this thing and I can just convert it to, I have three color scheme, blue, silver, black. So by default it is blue. So I have converted, changed into blue. Okay. Next, when I go to any option, I just keep my mouse here. So there is a screen tip here, such as fill color, color the background of selected. So there are screen tip style also. Screen tip style. Show features description in screen tip. don't show features description in screen tip and don't show screen tips. If you select don't show screen tip, it will never show you screen tip there. Okay. So just let it be on. Then from here you can choose your default font, such as I have chosen here Arial, font size 12. View I can choose page break preview, page layout view, normal view. So I have made it normal view. And how many sheet I want in my Excel. So I have selected here 5. So if I want 6, I can make it 6 and press OK. When I press take a new sheet, so I can see there is 6 sheets here now. The options we are studying is for all Excel application. It is not related to one single file. It will affect your Excel application. Okay. Then you can see I just type a name here and it is my name, and when I drag it you can see lot more name are also here. Okay. Such as
okay.
I type any product here. When I drag, so it is not related to me. Let's see. Some other thing is available. No, not available. So basically I want to tell you that just like we do January, February, when we drag, we can see there are the list of whole month is available here. Okay. So this happens, and how I have used it. This is because of custom list. The list, the product or any list which we use many times in our daily routine, I just store in this edit custom list option. When I press it, there are some lists by default, Sunday, Monday, January, February. But this you can see Sandeep, Harish, Vikas, Mahesh, the list I have created. Palwal, rice, sugar, milk, wheat, pen drive. These list is created by me.
So you just add it.
Yes, you can add it. Now let's see how to add it. Suppose I'm creating a new list for fruits, apple, banana, strawberry. And what are the fruits? I never eat.
Orange.
Yeah. Mango. So this is the list I want to apply in my custom list. I'll go to Excel option popular and this edit custom list. And there is a import button here. Import option here. Either I can type any list I can type by my hand, or I can import. When I press this and import, you can see there is a list. Just press add.
Okay.
Now when I press, when I enter any one of the name which is available in the list, I can drag it down.
Oh, I see. That's amazing.
Now, if you delete it, never mind, it will be there always. Okay. In any of your files you can use.
That's good.
Now let's move to other options, formulas. in formula, sometimes we put some formulas here, such as I want to add some values and I apply a sum formula here. For sum formula, we use alt plus equal to. Alt equal to, when we press it, automatically puts your sum formula here. So in this cell I have applied a formula. When I change any of the value, I can see there is a immediate change in values. It does immediate calculation here. But sometimes you change the value and it will not calculate, such as when if you go in formula and this workbook calculation, when it is set to manual, then you change any value, it will never show you updation. For making updation, you need to calculate the value. You just press calculate now, or you can press F9 from your keyboard. So when I press that, then it calculates, because the calculation options are set to manual here. This option also available in formula tab. This one, this. Okay. So when set it to automatic, then we find whenever we are changing, it shows me dynamic updation here. Okay.
Okay.
So this option you can,
but it is by default automatic, right?
Yes, it is by default. I am telling you that somehow if it is not working, then how will you correct it? Okay.
Yeah, it's, yeah.
Then we have a thing. Suppose I have entered a formula here, 10 plus this cell, the cell below this formula, and here I apply a formula again, 10 plus the upper cell. So what it will do?
Automatically it will give you
the answer. It will generate error. Okay, what is the error? Circular reference. Circular reference means when your formula is the formula becomes interdependent with each other. So it will show you this type of arrow and this circular reference arrow. These type of calculations are not allowed in Excel. But let's see, if you are in engineering, sometime you will be require a formula like this, which need to be calculated. But how many times you can decide? That 10 times it will calculate, then no matter. So we will go in Excel option in formula, then there is enable iterative calculation. How many times you want to do a repetition, iteration between this. Okay. When you press enable iterative calculation and press OK, it will calculate the value.
Yes,
because when you get when you are done with your engineering degree, these type of calculation in future you may be required.
Okay. Yeah.
So this is the point for solving the circular reference formula. But it practically we don't use it. Normally we never require for that. Okay. I just
right.
And we have two types of referencing here. One is absolute referencing, second is relative referencing. What is that? You can see there is A, B, C, D, E, G. It is written for column, and 1, 2, 3 is for row. So if I want to redirect to this cell A2, then I want to write equal to A and 2. That means I am referring to this cell. This is called absolute reference. That means the reference is understood by, it is predefined actually, preset. But okay, what is relative reference? Suppose you say from this cell I want to move one cell, one column in plus and two column in minus. So you will reach here. So this is called relative references, where you are standing on a point and you don't know where to go. You just have the steps only, that four steps ahead, three steps downwards, this kind of thing. So this kind of things, it is done by your relative reference. We will do from formula in R1 C1 reference style. This is relative reference. When you check it, you will find the column which are the name with A, B, C, D, you will find there is 1, 2, 3, 4 in rows and in columns. Okay. Now what I was saying, I press equal to, and when I refer to any cell, it will show me the
I see cell. Okay.
Okay. So when I go down, you can see row is minimizing. Row 2, column 2. I am, this cell where I am writing, it is row 0, column 0. So it is showing me RC. When I move one column ahead, I can see row 0, column 1. One row ahead, row 1, column 1. Okay.
Okay.
For reverse value, it will show the negative value. In columns, you will find the negative values for columns. So this kind of referencing style we use in RVBA. For macros, we need this type of style. In Excel, we generally we don't want this kind of thing. So we will go to formula and make it off. Okay. Then, when you type, suppose you want to type check number, or maybe that number which is starting with 0. But when I am starting with 0 and I type, I press enter, then the 0 lost here. I lost 0.
Yeah.
So what I will do, I will type apostrophe here, then I will type 0. Then I type any of the number, then it will remain. Okay.
Do that again.
You will press apostrophe, then
okay,
you will type 0 and any number, it will be there.
Okay, get it.
For entering check number type of value, we use these things. Okay. But it has done, but it is showing me some error. Why? You can see there is green tag here.
Yes.
In both values. And this sign, when you click on this, it will show you the error. What is the error? Number is stored as a text. Means the zero accepted only in text. The front zero. Okay. When I press convert to number, it will convert to number. Okay, but for remaining, it will show you the same error. So basically, what I am telling you, the tag is coming in green. If you want to change the color of this error, so this option is also available in that, this color. You can choose the color from here. And what should be the rules for checking these kind of errors? So there are rules which HR checked. So under what rule it had proceeded? Number formatted as text or preceded by an apostrophe. Okay. I don't want to see this error. I just uncheck this. Okay. I will never find any error here. The error will be there, but it will not show you.
Yeah.
So these are error checking rules. So I make it default like.
Yes.
Sometimes what happens, we just do spell checking. Suppose I am typed here two wrong spellings. Okay.
Okay.
Then I press F7 function key F7 for checking spellings. So I can see there is a suggestion for my small word. I just ignore it and it is showing me for capital also, but in your Excel you will not show you will not find any this option for any capital case. Why? Because in your Excel option, if you go to proofing, this option will be checked in your Excel. Ignore word in uppercase. So when you press F7, so it will not show you any error. It will directly show you the error check for previous one, the smaller case only. And I just ignore once, so spelling check is complete. So there are some spelling check options. This ignore word in uppercase. Then rest of all are not important, so I am telling you the important one only, but the kind of errors you get while operating on Excel. Okay. So sometimes what we find, I want to type C between these brackets, but when I press enter, it's working fine. I just make it like previous. Because even I have not changed that. Okay. Maybe I have removed that. I just press this one, RT. Nothing happened. Let me see, there is some error I have rectified, I think. Yes, there is nothing. Okay, I have removed that. What happens? Suppose this about is written wrong, or we will try this TM. TM. So it is converted in this trademark symbol.
Okay.
So what's going on here actually, by this typing this C and R, you will find copyright sign and registered sign. Okay. So I have removed that. What is happening when you type any value, it just got converted from dictionary automatically. So when you go to proofing in autocorrect option, in your first option autocorrect, there is a thing, replace text as you type. When you uncheck that, so this kind of conversion will never be done. Now I can type TM here and no conversion will be done. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes if I want to write TM and it got converted in this thing, so I don't have any option. So the option is available here in proofing, autocorrect option, and this one. Uncheck this option, replace text as you type. Okay. But you can use for your sake also. You just type anything. Suppose I will just type ml and it should be changed with Murli. I just add in that. Okay. So when I type ml, it will be converted in Murli. Yes, sir.
Okay.
So the shortcut, the names, or punchline, you can add by this option in your Excel. Second thing, what happens? Sometimes I am typing any web address. Sometimes I type any email ID. So it got converted in blue. It becomes an hyperlink. If I don't want this hyperlink conversion, I can make it correct from this proofing option, autocorrect option. I will go in second tab, auto format, as you type internet and network path with hyperlink. When you uncheck that, you will find when you type, it will never convert in any hyperlink. Because what happens when we type in hyperlink, we want to correct it, and by mistake if it is clicked, so you will find this link will be redirected to website, and if you click mail option, it will open a mail for you.
That's right.
Okay. So if you don't want to do these things, so just make it off. So this proofing, autocorrect option, auto format as you like. Uncheck or check, you can choose.
Okay.
Now let's know about saving your workbook. Suppose that in my desktop, you can see there are some files like this sign, exclamation sign is available in Excel sheet. Basically, this is these files are used for VBA programming. Why? Because while under VBA, I type any code. If I save it to a normal workbook, my VBA code will be lost. So I need to save these files with Excel macro enabled workbook. I need to choose Excel macro enabled workbook. Okay. But here you can see my default folder is coming as desktop and save as type is Excel macro enabled workbook. So I can make it default, make this option default by going into save option of this Excel option, and here I can choose the default format. Okay.
Okay.
And the default file is location, which I have set as desktop. So I can give the path of that here. Okay. Where you want to make your files to default save, you just give it the path to it, the folder's path.
Okay. Yeah.
Sometimes what happens is, suppose your Excel accidentally closed or crashed by power failure or anything. So when you reopen your Excel, you will find if you are working on any workbook, you will find a side option for recovering Excel, that file. So this recovery happened due to this option, save auto recover information every 10 minutes. Your Excel saves every information after 10 minutes without saying anything. Okay. If you lost any file in power failure, so it will be available till the Excel reopening in this location. You can make your this location as default also. You can choose by your own. Okay. If you uncheck that, it will never save anything.
How to get to that location?
Just copy this location, open your folder, and here in address bar you just paste this location, and here you will find the files. But it will be available till your Excel opening in 2010, Excel 2010. If you never saved any workbook, so it will be available after many times reopening, after lot of reopening. But in Excel 2007, if you have opened Excel, the option will be same here. Do you want to recover or you want to delete? Either you recover or it will delete the file. It is like that.
Okay.
When we are dealing with very huge files, what happens? We can't use this option. We don't want to use this option because we are dealing with very large files, and you know, saving these type of files take a lot of time. And in every 10 minutes, when my file is getting saved, so it will be a big problem because I can't see my data. I can't access my data because it is every time saving. So I have an exception for disable auto recover for this workbook only. You just check that, and the opened workbook you will see in this list. That okay. Workbook will be here. So what will happen while working on that type of files? The file will not be saved automatically. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
For now, I am stopping, and